The Tools Palette panel in BricsCAD offers a central location to access blocks, hatches, command tools, etc. You can access tool palettes either by inputting tool palettes command using the keyboard, or you can click on the tool palettes icon in the tools panel. Tool palettes command now has a new user experience because tool palettes interface is revamped in BricsCAD V23. In the tool palettes panel, various tools are grouped in palette tabs, and the current palette in the tab is highlighted in a blue line. Since the tabs have fixed height, the full name of some of the tabs will not be visible. Just hover over the tab to see the full name. Using the up and down arrow keys, user can see the hidden tabs. In tool palettes, the various tools are systematically categorized, and you can have easy access to the frequently used commands in BricsCAD. For example, if you click on the BIM tab, you can see most of the frequently used BIM related tools, which are further categorized based on the application. You can easily invoke the quick draw command, for example, by clicking on the quick draw icon. You can copy paste a tool from one tool palette to another. For example, right click on the quick draw tool in the BIM tool palettes and click on copy. Activate the BricsCAD tab, right click and click on paste. Now right click on the tool icon, click on rename to rename it, or delete to delete it. In the upper right corner of the tool palettes, there is a search icon using which you can search a particular tool. If I search for arrange command, only that particular tool will appear. When you click on these three vertical dots, you will get a context menu with a number of options to add a text, a separator, update tool palettes, to create a new palette, etc. When you right click on the tool palette, you will get the same options. Using these icons, you can control the display of tools in the tool palettes. You can have tool icon and label view, which is the default view, or icon view without labels, or you can have a list view. Using the plus icon in the lower right corner of the panel, you can add a separator, text, and tool. Click on Add Separator to add a separator in the panel. Click on Add Text to add a custom text. I'll type my favorite tools. Click on Add Tool option to add a tool to the tool palettes. Now you have got the Customize dialog box. In this dialog box, tools are categorized in various tabs. We have Menus tab, Toolbars tab, Ribbon tab, Keyboard tab, etc. When you click on the Keyboard tab, you will see a list of frequently used keyboard shortcuts in BricsCAD. The Ctrl 0 keyboard shortcut is used to perform clear screen. But when you select this keyboard shortcut, you can see options to control the display of various interface elements. Click on Show command line, right click and click on Add to current tool palettes option. Now you can see that tool in the tool palettes. Next, click on Hide command line, right click and click on Add to current tool palette option. Now that tool is also added. Using the search option, you can also search for a particular tool. For example, click on Menu tab and search for Extrude command. Now the Extrude command is shown. Right click and click on Add to current tool palette. Now the Extrude tool is added. Likewise, any tool can be searched and added to the tool palettes. Now let us execute these tools. Click on Hide command line when you want to hide the command line, and click on Show command line to make the command line visible. Click on Extrude to execute the Extrude command. Using the tool palettes, you can create entities with predefined properties. Click on the plus sign, add tool. Now the menus tab is active. Click on the plus sign corresponding to draw and click on line. You can see the list of entities in BricsCAD. Click on line, right click, add to current tool palette and OK. Next, let's create a new layer with the name wall. Click on layers icon in the tool panels, add layer, type wall. Next, go to tool palettes, select the line tool which we have created, right click, click on properties, and here you can change the properties of this line. Let's change the color to yellow and layer to wall and give OK. Now click on the line tool to invoke the line command, and when you create a line, this particular line will be created with the given properties. Let's open a new drawing and create a line there. You can see that this line is drawn in yellow color and the wall layer is automatically created in this drawing. If required, you can create a flyout on the line tool. For that, just right click on the line tool and click on manage flyout options. Just activate enable the flyout and you can keep the required entities in the flyout. If you don't want ray, spline and infinite line, you can uncheck these options. Click on OK. Now if you click on the line tool, there is a flyout and you can choose any entity from the entities in the flyout. Click on polyline. Now you can create a polyline. To create a new palette, just right click on the tool palette and click on new palette and give a palette name. Click on add. Now we have created an empty tool palette onto which you can add tools of your choice. Right click on the palette tab and click on rename palette to rename the palette and click on delete palette to delete it. Hence, tool palettes in BricsCAD offers a central location to easily access and execute any command. This completes the tutorial on improved tool palettes in BricsCAD V23. Thanks for your time.